You are no longer strangers and sojourners, but citizens together with the saints and members of the household of God. Please stand. O God, let our mouth proclaim your praise
and your glory all the day long.
The night has passed, and the day lies open before us. Let us pray with one heart and one mind. As we rejoice in the gift of this new day, so may the light of your presence, O God, set our hearts on fire with love for you, now and forever. Amen. Amen. Let us say together the Venite. Come, let us sing to the Lord.
Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before God's presence with thanksgiving, and raise to the Lord with a shout with psalms. For you are a great God. You are great above all gods. In your hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are yours also. The sea is yours, for you made it, and your hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee, and kneel before the Lord our Maker.
For you are our God, and we are the people of your pasture, and the sheep of your hand.
Oh, that today we would hearken to your voice. Let us listen today to God's voice. Harden not your hearts, as your forebears did in the wilderness, at Meribah, and on that day in Massa, when they tempted me. They put me to rest, but they have seen my works.
40 years long I detested that generation and said,
these people are wavering in their hearts. They do not know my ways. So I swore in my wrath, they shall not enter into my rest. Praise to the holy and undivided Trinity, one God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans. Do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that, just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in a death like his, we will certainly be united with him in a resurrection like his. We know that our old self was crucified with him, so that the body of sin might be destroyed, and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is free from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The death he died to sin, once for all. But the life he lives to God. So you also must consider yourselves dead to sin and alive to God in Christ Jesus.
Thanks be to God.
Hallelujah. When Israel came out of Egypt, the house of Jacob from a people of strange speech. Judah became God's sanctuary, and Israel God's dominion. The sea beheld it and fled. Jordan turned and went back. The mountains skipped like rams, and the little hills like young sheep. What ailed you, O sea, that you fled? O Jordan, that you turned back? You mountains that you skipped like rams, you little hills like young sheep. Tremble, O earth, at the presence of God, at the presence of the God of Jacob, who turned the hard rock into a pool of water, and flint stoned into a flowing spring.
A reading from the Gospel of Matthew. After the Sabbath, as the first day of the week was dawning, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord, descending from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing was white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. For he has been raised, as he said. Come, see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples, he has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly, Jesus met them and said, "Greetings!" And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God.
May I speak to you in the name of God. Amen. Many of my friends know my passion for Celtic spirituality, and the testimony of the Celtic saints has inspired me. And my search to fulfill my desire to understand more about Celtic tradition, I went to Lindisfarne Island in Northumberland. And there I rediscovered the meaning of worship. And while I was there with Father David Adam, I learned that when we celebrate in worship the mighty acts of God, we're not so much concerned with remembering as with entering into the events. You are emphasizing the eternal rather than the historical. When we worship, we speak about the now. The eternal is continuous in the Kairos, in God's time. God comes to us now. God is born again today. It's also now that our risen Lord appears to us. In the same way, it's now that God is molding and reshaping creation. It's also now that the Spirit descends. More than ever, we need the Church to rediscover this understanding of eternal and Kairos in the way we worship. Even though we are physically separate, we still church. We still here. And God is here with us in our crisis, in our sorrows, in our longings, in our mournings. In 2004, a Roman Catholic nun, Yoni Buist, offered a workshop on liturgical presence at the altar, and we spent a few days talking about worship. My colleague, Reverend Joy Mel, and I took the workshop together, and I recall one evening we were talking about the experience of meditating in Psalms. We chanted Psalm 30, and the music was from Sime Monteiro, and I can share later with you where you can find this psalm. But Sime, the musician, she focused on the verse 6 that says, "Weeping may spend the night, but joy comes in the morning. Weeping may spend the night, but joy comes in the morning." As the Celtic tradition teaches, nature have its ways to speak to us about God's presence. God's creation is a reminder that we are in this eternal cycle of birth, growth, death, and rebirth. Through the promise of resurrection, we too live in hope that our sorrow and mourning will end, that our night will turn to a bright morning, a new day. God is not indifferent to our pain. God is not indifferent to your pain. God is watching the world right now in suffering. And God's heart hurts, just like as the heart of a mother when vigiling over her sick child. And just like a mother, God says to us, "Do not be afraid." And that's the same way Jesus addresses to Mary Magdalene. He says, "Do not be afraid. You will see wonders. But conquer fear and death through faith." Christ is risen indeed. And alleluia is because God can transform our night in a bright day. God is here with me, with you, with our beloved ones. May God bless us in this journey. Amen.
I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Our prayers begin on page 6. Hear our cry, O God,
and listen to our prayer.
Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Amen.
Help us, O God, our Savior.
Deliver us and forgive us our sins.
Look upon your congregation.
Give your people the blessing of peace.
Declare your glory among the nations.
And your wonders among all peoples.
Do not let the oppressed be ashamed or turned away.
Never forget the lives of your poor.
Continue your loving kindness to those who know you.
In your favor to those who are true of heart.
Satisfy us by your loving kindness in the morning.
So shall we rejoice and be glad all the days of our lives.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray.
Almighty God, who through your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, overcame death and opened to us the gate of everlasting life, grant that we, who celebrate with joy the day of the Lord's resurrection, may be raised from the death of sin by your life-giving Spirit, through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
On this most holy day, we pray for the Church, the earth, the world, those in need, and all the members of God's family, responding to each petition with the words, "Hear our prayer." We pray, O God, for all the churches around the globe, for their bishops and clergy, for the newly baptized, for the believers who cannot assemble for worship, for faithful endurance during this time of sorrow and distress, and for a deepening sense of your presence among us. O God, you are our temple. In your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, O God, for the well-being of creation, for the health of seas and rivers and lakes, for the Anacostia and the Potomac and the Chesapeake, and for the will to care for your earth. O God, you are our rainbow of promise. In your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, O God, for peace and justice in the world, for an end to war and international turmoil, for concord in our troubled society, for the heads of state, legislators, and local civic leaders, that they enact wise procedures to deal with the coronavirus. O God, you are our mighty fortress. In your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, O God, for all who are facing the coronavirus, for all who mourn their dead, all who have contracted the virus, those who are quarantined or stranded away from home, those who have lost their employment, those who fear the present and the future. We pray for physicians, nurses, and home health aides, medical researchers, and the World Health Organization. Fill the aching in our hearts with your merciful power. O God, you are our everlasting arms. In your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, O God, for all in need, for those commended to our prayers, Mona, Paul, Maggie, Lisa, Ridgely, Bill, Tessie, Melissa, Larry, Brian, Stephanie, Brenda, Gabrielle, Renee, Anandina, Dolly, Betsy, Murray, Santa Helena, Steve, Bertha, Bill, Vitorina, Mary, John, Nancy, Esther, Antonio, Ian, Doris, Lindsay, Tricia, Daroni, Maria, Joanne, Kim, Joan, Will, John, Tommy, Keith, Kathy, Jesse, Nancy, Ernie, Melissa, Kathy, Ron, Alex, Gloria, Beth, George, Sylvia, the Ortiz family, Catalina and her siblings. For those suffering for the faith, for those who are poor, hungry, and homeless, for those who are sick and those awaiting death, and for those we name before you here. O God, you are the healer of our every ill. In your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray, O God, for the desires of our hearts. O God, you are our heart's desire. In your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive our thanks for all who died in the faith, and bring us at the final resurrection into your everlasting life, where sorrows will be no more. O God, our beginning and our end, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Into your gracious hands, O God, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy, through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
Let us pray together the general thanksgiving on page 9. Almighty God, maker of all mercies, we, your worthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ, for the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies, that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth the praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service, and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days, through Jesus Christ our Lord, to know with you and the Holy Spirit, the honor and glory, throughout all ages. Amen. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time, with one accord, to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions, as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Amen. Let us bless the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit.